Hello ladies and welcome to my YouTube channel. We will talk about what to do and what to not do when a man is pulling away. But today I have a special guest. It's Matthew Cost. He is the founder of the Forever Woman program. This is an amazing topic. Thank you so much, Matthew, for being on my YouTube channel.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
It's really my pleasure. I was watching your videos and a lot of ladies came to me and said, it would be great to have Matthew on your YouTube channel that I can interview you. So you're a big name in the industry. So I'm really glad that you took the time to be on this Zoom call with me. Matthew, can you just introduce yourself for the ladies that don't know you yet, even if I know that there's not a lot?
Sure. My name is Matthew Cost and I'm the founder of the Forever Woman program. If you've heard of that, it's kind of my flagship program. A lot of women are in it. I've helped women, single women turn things around for themselves and get into great relationships. I've helped women heal broken hearts, get back with their exes. I've helped marriages, fix broken marriages before. And so, I've done a lot of stuff in the industry. I've been teaching in the industry for a long time. And so I'm actually really honored to be here with you right now, Alex. So thank you so much.
No, it's really my pleasure because, you know, for the ladies that are in my community, most of the time they are doing the same mistake and they have the same goal. It's to be happy in love. And I found that you have a lot of advice that you can give specifically when a man is pulling away. And most of the time we give like, okay, this is what you need to do. We want to give them the secret formula. But what I found really interesting with this topic is what a woman should never do when a man is distant. What would be the best tip that you can share?
So one of the things that women come to me with all the time is this guy's pulled away. He's disappeared on me. He's ignoring me right now. You know, what should I do? And a lot of times they've already done things. And the most common mistake that I see is that women will, what they'll do is I teach a concept called leaning back. And so they'll kind of lean back a little bit and let the guy come back to them. But as soon as he comes back, they'll use something on him that I call a connection barrier. And a connection barrier is like slamming a door on his face, right? And it makes him feel like most women, when they're doing this, they want to feel like they're being seen and that they're being heard and that they're being valued and their feelings are being recognized. But what it actually does is it makes a guy feel like he's not welcome around you. Instead, what you want to do is you want him to feel like he regrets pulling away in the first place and like he wants to come and just, you know, have you back in his arms again. And so a connection barrier are things like, when a guy comes back, she'll like attack him, right? And she'll yell at him and cuss him out and, you know, tell him how horrible he is, which might make her feel good in the moment, but it's not going to make him want to come back to her. It's only going to make him want to pull further away. And so you have to make sure that you're not doing stuff like that. Another common one that I see is that women will, as soon as he comes back, she will try to tell him how bad she feels and try to communicate that and just tell him, be like, you don't know how you made me feel. And this is, and it's totally understandable, right? Because you want him to feel what's going on with you, right? And you're in pain. And so you're like, hey, this is what's going on with me. And there's a time to do that. But that time isn't right when he shows back up, right when he starts messaging you again. You don't want to do it right then.
So that's really good advice that I really love, because sometimes we want to express our feelings, but it can still make a man pull away and it will not give you the results you want. I have coached some women and they do the opposite. So when a guy comes back, he's pulling away, they will just do lean back. They understand the process of lean back. But when he comes back, they will share the love. They will, oh, I missed you. Thank you so much for coming back. What do you think of this behavior? Do you think it's a good idea or it's a mistake that they are doing?
I think that's a mistake. I mean, you can do that and it could work. But I think generally speaking, it's kind of a mistake, right? And the reason, it kind of depends, right? It depends on your situation, because I get women all the time and they're in these different situations, right? They might be married. They might be in kind of an exclusive relationship. They might be in a committed relationship, or they might just start dating some guy. And so it depends kind of on where you are and what kind of situation you're in as to what exactly you want to do. Because if you're just dating a guy and he comes back, right, and he pulled away, you might want to think first, like, because sometimes there's a woman that was on one of my live streams not too long ago, and she was like, yeah, there's this guy and he pulls away every day. He's caught and cold every single day. And I was like, what do you mean by that? Like, what do you mean he's hot and cold every day? And she's like, well, he disappears in the evening and then he contacts me again the next morning. And so he's gone after like 6 o'clock. And I'm like, I'm like, so you think that's him pulling away? Right. And so there's kind of this thing out there where it's like, okay, you need to figure out whether it's normal behavior, right? Is this normal behavior? Or is this some kind of thing that's abnormal, that is not even necessarily malicious by intent, but might be him like not being attracted or not being interested in you. And so he pulls away, and you know, it's something where he's just not that invested. He's not that interested. He's stringing you along. He's breadcrumbing you, right? And so you're like, okay, what should I do in this instance? And if you're in one of those situations where he's breadcrumbing you and he's kind of lost interest or he's not really valuing you, he's taking you for granted, what you want to do is you want him to earn you back, right? You want him to prove that he's interested. You want him to show you that he's going to invest in you, that he's going to treat you like the queen, the goddess, the amazing woman that you are, the type of woman who deserves to be treated well, who deserves to have a guy who comes to her and absolutely loves her and treats her like she's the most amazing woman he's ever met in his life, the woman that he wants to be with forever, right? And it might take a little bit of time before he starts doing that. And so you want him, if he pulls away and he's been gone for a few days and you're worried, the best thing that you can do when he comes back is to make him prove that he's really interested and that he wants something real with you and that he's going to treat you the way that you want him to treat you.
So the question that I'm sure all the women will ask is, how long do we have to lean back? So if a man is pulling away, do we have to lean back until he reaches out to me? Or do I wait 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 weeks? How long does it take?
Well, if it's been more than a week and the guy's disappeared and you're like still trying to figure this out and you're not in like a committed relationship, you're not married, none of those things are going on, you should be out there dating other people. You should be working on yourself. You should be shifting your focus to the things that you actually want in your life. You should be conditioning your emotional experience so that you're living and loving your life every single day. That's the first thing that you should be doing during that time. But there's actually another thing that you can do, and it's you can test. You can test to see what's actually going on with a guy. And the way that you do this is you can send him a text message and just send him something that kind of gets his attention and sees what's going on with him at the moment. And if you do that, then you can kind of figure out, right? Like if a week goes by, 4 days go by, 5 days go by, and you haven't heard from him, and he's been pursuing you, he's been contacting you normally, he's normally initiating things, he's normally taking you out on dates or any of that kind of stuff, it's okay to send him a text message and just, you know, just to say hi and see what's going on and just initiate that contact where you're opening a door for him. One of the things that I hear a lot from women when we talk about the leaning back concept is they like to jump from one extreme to the other, right? They're like, yeah, exactly. Leaning forward, and they're like, you know, texting all the time. And then I'm like, oh, lean back. And they're like, oh, so never initiate, never contact him. And that's not what we're saying at all, right? That's not like, you can still contact him. You can still initiate conversations with him and talk to him and show him you're interested in him if he's moving forward, if his energy is coming towards you, right? And so that's kind of the distinction there. Was there something you want to say about that?
Yes, because basically, you know, I feel that this is really good advice. The one thing that I want to share with you is like, sometimes they don't know what to write to this guy. So I want to ask you, do you have like some example of text message when we talk about the Forever Women program? Is it something that you would just drive them into like some examples? Because it's difficult for them to not talk about their love or their anger, as you have said. So how can we create this amazing text message? And do you talk about it in a Forever Women program?
Yeah. So in my program, The Forever Woman, there's a 4-word text message that's specifically designed to get his attention and get him interested and make him, it's kind of like a shocker is what it does. Is it's not too serious, but it's not too lighthearted. And what it does is it kind of wakes him up and it makes him realize that he's kind of been pulling away, or that he's been ignoring you, or that he's been doing something where he hasn't been initiating contact. And it makes him realize, and I've had women use this. We've had hundreds of women use this at this point and tell us their results from it. And we've had women who have had guys who, you know, apologized and they're like, hey, I'm sorry for pulling away. Well, they don't usually use pull away, but they're like, hey, I'm sorry for going cold on you. Or I'm sorry for, like, you know, going radio silence, or I'm sorry I haven't talked to you in a bit, you know, like, this is what's going on. Or sometimes they'll just start picking up the conversation where it was before, you know, because sometimes people get busy and they're doing other things and their priority shifts over to something else. And, you know, they want to connect and sometimes they just don't. And it can also be that, you know, maybe he's in a situation where he's not sure if he should contact you or not, because maybe he's been told that he's supposed to lean back and that you're supposed to chase him by some men's dating advice out there, right? And so there could be a whole bunch of different things going on. And so absolutely, we have a text message that you can send him that can kind of pull him in if you're interested in that. The Forever Woman program that I have, I'm guessing there's going to be a link around here somewhere.
Yes, I will put all the info about like your YouTube channel, your program, because I found it that it's really important for a woman to receive the text message to know exactly what they will be able to do. And I'm sure that you help thousands of them just making sure that this guy will say, I'm sorry for being distant. You know, we know when we do a mistake, and so you will become as a high value woman. So yeah, I will include the link just under this video. So please feel free to click on it and to discover this amazing program. This
is And I just want to say one other thing about that. Click on the link, go and watch the video. The program's actually free. If you want to get the program, you can get it for free and you'll get the text message for free and my entire system for free. And if you decide you want to stay a part of the program and a part of our community, you can end up staying as a part of it. And there's a monthly cost for that. So,
yeah. So this is why I feel that it's really good, because we can have advice from Love Coach. Sometimes it's difficult for us to do one-on-one session, but to have a group community, it's just amazing. I would like to just talk about what are those don'ts that women should not do when a man is pulling away. Not show anger, not show maybe some too much love, making sure that they will use the barriers that are really good for communication. What are the mistakes that you're seeing with the people that are on your live stream and your program?
I'd say the biggest mistake, other than what a lot of women do, which is they wait and then they like attack. The other big mistake that a lot of women will make is they focus on him, right? And it's all about him and what he's doing. And so they're just sitting around, you know, like thinking about him, what's going on with him, you know, what is he doing? Why isn't he contacting me? Does he love me? Is everything okay? Right. And they start sending, and a lot of times they'll start sending him messages like that. right? Which is, it's just a total no-no. Even if you're not sending him messages like that, you still don't want to be in that mindset. You want to be in a mindset of loving your life and enjoying your life and focusing on things that allow you to grow and create a better life for yourself, that create happiness for yourself, you know, have things that are going on in your life, hobbies and goals and things that you're working on, you know, have things that make it so that, you know, one of the things that I say is your focus, whatever you focus on, you feel, and whatever you feel, you receive. And so if you're focusing on what's not going right in the situation, you're going to start feeling that all the time. And if you're feeling that all the time, you're going to welcome more of it in. You're going to start looking for more of it, and you're going to experience more of it. And it's just going to feel really bad. And instead, you want to feel really good. And so you want to focus on the things that you want, the things that you want to create, the things that you're grateful for, the things that you appreciate about your life and your world and everything that's going on, the fact that you have this great information at your fingertips that you can watch anytime you want because, you know, you have this amazing YouTube channel with tons of great advice on it. You know, just focus on the things that you appreciate in your life and you'll end up feeling a lot better. And when men do come to you, if they pull away and come back, they'll feel better about coming back to you, and the connection that you have with them will be so much greater. And so really you want to focus on the things that you want to feel in your life and the things that you want to receive in your life.
That's an amazing advice, because when we are in this type of situation, we feel that we are the problem. And as you said, sometimes the problem can come from work, from family, from being overwhelmed, being depressed. So it's not you the problem, ladies. And if you focus on the positive, whatever happened, you will feel confident. And when a guy will come back, if he feels like you're confident and positive, he will be more attracted by you. So it's really important. Last question that I want to ask you is social media. So I would tell the women that are following me that sometimes it's good to change their profile pictures just to make him react and make him feel that, oh my God, she's not waiting for me. She's like growing. She's learning also. If I'm putting away, I'm letting her just be herself. What do you think of this advice? And do you give advice on social media?
I don't tend to give a lot of advice on social media. I've never talked about that specifically, but that's great advice, right? Like it and if you're really worried about it, because sometimes what women will do is they'll like start stalking his social media and they're like, well, it says that he's online. Why isn't he talking to me? And then they'll like message him and be like, hey, are you talking to some other woman right now? And it's like, ah, cringe, right? And so if you are prone to doing stuff like that, what you want to do is just unfollow him on social media so that you don't see his feed, and then do, and then if you want to change your profile picture or start posting things of you going out and enjoying your life and living your life and creating what you want in your life, that's exactly when you should do that. That way he does see that. He will end up seeing it and it'll come across his feed and he'll be like, oh man, I should contact Kristen again. Like, why haven't I done that? It looks like she's having so much fun. Who's taking that photo? You know what? I want to be the one taking that photo. Like, let's see if we can hang out again. Right. And so absolutely. That's great advice.
Yeah. And at this moment, remember, don't show your anger. It's not the good time to do it. And make sure that you will follow the link and click on this For Women Forever program. That is really, really important. So you will have all the info for free. You can use this text message. And so you will be part of a community, which is really important, ladies. Matthew, thank you so much for being on this interview. I look forward to do more and more with you, if you agree.
Absolutely. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Sounds good. So if you have any question, feel free to ask in the comment section below. I will be here. And if there's a question for you, I will forward you. Matthew, I just feel that it was good advice to please don't do this mistake. If a man is pulling away, it's not over. It's really not over. Do you want to finish this video? I let always my invitee to finish the video. So if you have a final word that you want to say, Matthew, it's yours.
You know, I just want to say thank you everybody for watching right now. Thank you for trusting us in allowing us to be a part of your journey to creating the relationship that you've always wanted to have. I feel so honored to have so many amazing women. Our community that we have has so many beautiful and amazing and smart women from all over the world as a part of it. And so I just want to say thank you so much for allowing me to be here. And always remember, you are worth it.
That's good. Thank you so much, Matthew. And we will do a new video soon. If you have any idea of topic that you want us to talk, please feel free to leave a comment right below. Bye-bye, ladies.
Bye-bye.